the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Jill Calhoun.
Yeah, everybody's complaining how cold it is. That wind certainly makes it feel pretty cold. But don't forget, the winter hasn't been all that bad temperature-wise. Check it out. In fact, December was well above normal. And January was a little above normal, but now February has been a little bit below normal so far. But just by a degree, we think it's going to continue on the below normal side. Certainly colder than normal today. Normal highs are in the low 40s. We're going to be in low to mid 30s today. Clouds are starting to break, though, and I do think we'll see a little more sunshine the farther south and east you go. More sun you get. Brisk cold afternoon, though. There's winds still 10, 20 miles an hour. They're diminishing, but still, there's a bite to them. Clear, cold night tonight. Clouds do increase late tonight. Before they get here, though, I think some of the outlying countryside could be in the teens. Most of us low to mid 20s. Then tomorrow, clouds over. A little snow will arrive late in the day. I'm thinking after 4 or 5 o'clock, maybe mixed with a little sleet or rain in there. It's going to be a cold day, but temperatures above freezing. I don't anticipate any problems. First of all, precipitation is going to be patchy. It's going to be light. And temperatures should be above the freezing mark. Tomorrow night, maybe a little freezing drizzle or a little flurries around, but it's, again, not a big deal. You can see on our effort to sky cam, again, the skies are starting to clear out just a little bit. In Harrisburg right now, it's at 31 degrees, but those winds are northwest at 21. 28 up in Shamokin right now. And it's got to 31 in York. Hey, E-Town's up to freezing. 23, though, in State College. Add in the winds at 15, 20 miles an hour, making it feel like teens and 20s out there all across the board. So pretty cold one. We have been seeing some flurries still up around State College radar, picking up a few, but they've pretty much died out. Now those clouds are over us. You can see those bands of clouds swirling. The storm that was giving us problems the other day is well up into Canada now, but you can see how the clouds swirl around the lakes, pick up that moisture, and bring it down over us. But as they're coming over the mountains, you can see the clouds thinning out. Farther south and east you live, and they'll continue to thin. But here's the big weather story. Look at this big swirl out here in the Plains States. As Susan mentioned, they're having almost blizzard conditions in Kansas, Nebraska, now moving up into Missouri and Iowa. Chicago's going to get 4 or 5 inches of snow out of this, some ice down south. Worried about severe weather. Dallas down to Houston today. Heavy thunderstorms there into Louisiana. Here's the storm center moving up through the Texas Panhandle and up into the Plains States, spreading that snow. High pressure, though, continues to keep us dry. But what will happen is that brings in colder air and the warm air out ahead of the storm. The storm's going to be way off into the west, but as that warm air moves in, we'll get a little patchy, light precipitation. Some of it will be snow. Snow and rain mixed late tomorrow and tomorrow night, and maybe a little sleet mixed in. Then a secondary storm will develop. Looks like that's going to bring moisture back in off the ocean, bring us some rain heading into the day on Saturday. I think a little more than what the predictor's showing there. 35 degrees today. 38 tomorrow, and then a little rain or snow on Saturday. Mostly rain, though. It's not going to accumulate anything. Could get a little snow on the backside. Brisk, chilly day, but a little better for Sunday and Monday before more fun gets here as we get into Tuesday. Very, very active weather pattern.
Yeah, and it is cold out there.
It is, certainly now it is.
All right. Thank you, Joe.